Today, we're going to be taking a look at a septic system from 1974. The county has nothing on file for what the septic system looks like. They have no idea when it was put in, who put it in, or even what condition it's in. So today, I get to play the fun game of what's there, is it working, what needs to be fixed, and I'm going to take you with me. So let's go ahead, take a look, see what's on the site, and then we'll see what's going on inside. Alrighty, so as we walk up, we're going to see that we have a clean out right over here in this bush thing. That's going to be a little annoying to get that lid off, just because these bushes usually have thorns on them and they usually kind of stick you a little bit, but the ones I can see right now don't really look like they have any real thorns to them, so I think we might be okay. This is our manhole riser, so this should be in the middle of the tank. So that should be the front, the middle, and the back should be somewhere over here. So the tank is going to capture all of the solids. This is where you're going to pump out the tank. From here, we're going to have what should be a distribution box, I believe, all the way to a dry well there and a dry well over there. This type of system is very common in this area, right? Especially in Maryland. Nowadays, almost every newer distribution box is going to have a manhole riser at the surface. Oftentimes, you'll usually see a little 4-inch clean out, and before, you know, 2010, give or take, you wouldn't see a single access point at all. You'd have to dig it up to get to it. So this one should be much easier to see what's going on. That means somebody's touched this at some point in the past. They may have filed a permit, they may have lost the permit, or maybe they didn't do a permit. So now let's go ahead, pop open those lids, see what the inside looks like, and hopefully we don't find any nasty surprises. The very first thing we're gonna see when we pop open this riser is that safety catch right there. So in Baltimore County and throughout the entire state, you need to have a safety lid in this riser. The purpose of that is, let's just say you fall through here, that will catch you and at least give you a chance to get out of the hole before going into 5 feet of sewage. Now, they don't always come in plastic. Usually they'll come in concrete, but the newer systems are going to be these plastic systems. The reason everybody keeps using plastic, cost and ease of repair. So let's just say you do hit this with a lawnmower and you damage it to pieces. By having a plastic unit, it's way easier for you as a homeowner or as the installer to go ahead, remove the broken part, put in the new piece, and then everybody keeps on moving the way that they're wanting to move. So if you don't know if you have a safety lid in your riser or not, all you gotta do is pop the lid off. If you see another lid underneath, boom, there you go. Now you know you have a safety lid. Safety lids are super important. That's also why nowadays, whenever you have a plastic lid, everybody will use a goofy shape bit. So it'll be square, star, just a hex or something to that effect to where a kid can't easily get to it. Some systems you'll see people use Phillips heads. I don't usually recommend that because finding a Phillips head screwdriver is pretty easy and we don't want anybody accidentally popping that open and falling in and not having a good time. So we know what that looks like. So we gotta get that safety lid off, look inside, make sure the baffles are where they belong and everything's doing what it's supposed to do. But let's go take a look at the distribution box real quick. So what we're looking at right now is the distribution box. So that pipe will be our inlet line. This pipe will go to the dry well that's over on the other side. This one will go to the one behind us. This, I believe, is a dead pipe and they have to put that in there in order to keep a good seal. So in a minute, what we're gonna do is we're gonna poke at that one just to see if it's open or if it's been capped. The records didn't have any, there was no records on this, so there shouldn't be anything to our left at all. So let's go ahead and see where we're going and what's happening. Generally in this area, you would only really see two pits on a house from 1970. Every now and again, you might see three, but the odds of three being there are very slim. So that extra pipe, I don't expect it's gonna go anywhere. A lot of times you'll see people actually put in an additional drain field with the dry wells, but based off of those little speed levelers, which are those little holes, doesn't look to be that way. Usually those speed levelers will be set higher than the drain field line if there's a drain field in the system. The reason why is you want to use the newer system to give the older system, which is the dry wells, time to recover. So because of the placement, I don't think there's gonna be another one, but the only way to tell is to start poking at stuff and see what happens. So we're gonna get that safety lid off, grab our mirror flashlight, look inside the tank, and hopefully we don't find anything crazy. Looking inside the tank, everything looks like it's actually pretty good. The interior looks fine, and we can see the baffle in the system looks like a concrete baffle. Now, when we're gonna go run through the camera through the pipes, we'll be able to confirm the baffle's actually there and doing what it's supposed to do, but this is what the inside of the tank looks like. Whenever you have your system pumped, looked at, maintained, anything like that, it's super important to make sure you're getting that baffle looked at. The reason why, the baffle in the septic tank, its sole purpose is to block all that floating stuff in the on the top of the water from getting in the pipe and causing problems in the distribution box, the drain fields, drywells, whatever the absorption system is. The goal of your septic tank is to capture solids, and you gotta make sure you pump it out every now and again. Now, generally in Maryland, the University of Maryland and Health Department's recommendations every 3 or 5 years. I usually recommend, if it's a family of four, depending on if you work from home or not, you're probably pumping every 2 or 3 years, give or take. It really depends on usage and occupancy. The more people living in that house, the more you use that toilet, guess what? You're filling up the tank a little bit more often than you probably think you are. The way that we measure the solids in the tank is with this fancy little fella. This is called a sludge judge. Basically what it is a pole with a ping pong ball that we stick into the tank and we measure the solids. Goal behind doing this is that you want to see how full is the system. Now, guidance is 30% is when you want to get the tank pumped out. So we want to see how full are we. If we've got 5 feet of liquid, 18 inches of solids, guess what? Now we're basically at that 30% mark. It's time to get this thing pumped out. But if we got 5 feet of liquid and 2 inches of solids, yeah, you're good. You don't have to worry about pumping it right now. I recommend that you have the pumper check the sludge before they pump it, just so you can see where are you and how much time did it take to get to that volume. So if it's been 2 years and the pumper's like, here about, a few inches, you're not terrible. Maybe next time you wait 3 years, right? Or maybe if they hit it and they're like, oh God, it's like 50% full. Maybe you waited a little bit too long. From the septic tank, that's where all your solids are gonna go, right? You gotta deal with the water somehow. That's where the distribution box comes into play. We've already talked about this a little bit, but we've got one pipe going to the pit over there and the other pipe going to the pit over there. Now, basically, whenever you see a new system like this, you're gonna have a manhole riser, and a lot of times they'll make them out of plastic. And the reason that they'll be made out of plastic is for the longevity of the system. Sewer gas is incredibly corrosive, and so what'll happen is if you have a concrete distribution box, like most concrete systems have, you're gonna run into corrosion issues, right? What'll happen is the gas will get in there, it'll chew up the concrete, and eventually that concrete will lose some of its strength until either roots get in or it collapses. I see it all the time. It's always terrible because it costs a lot of money to get fixed. So what a lot of contractors have been doing have been switching to plastic boxes. The cost of installation is still roughly about the same, no matter how you slice it. Anytime you get any work done on your house, it's never gonna be fun or cheap. I'm a homeowner. I know. I get it. Even people that are not in my trade, I have to hire for my house, right? And it's always expensive and it always sucks. But that's why you want to go with the quality over getting somebody who's cheap and doing it quick, right? Now, for this particular one, we ran into a little bit of an issue with the sewer line. So whenever you're looking at a septic system or even public water or sewer, you want to make sure you look at the piping. And the reason why it's important to look at the piping is that we can see what's going on inside of there. This particular one, basically, the pitch is wrong on the entire thing, and there was a bunch of solids and debris stuck in the pipe, meaning that they're basically clogged several points throughout the system. So if you don't address it, you run the risk of that pipe completely getting obstructed and all that juice coming back to the house, and nobody wants that. The only way that you ever see these sorts of things before you get to the clogging point is if you run a camera through there, right? So if you're getting an inspection done, make sure you're getting a camera added on as well. If you're doing a repair, let's just say you do have a clog, have the plumber toss a camera through the pipe so we can see what might have caused that clog. Bellies are one of the main causes for clogs, and a belly is just when the pipe is no longer pitched correctly or it's starting to pond. So what can happen is you're introducing a friction point, basically, where the water that's carrying the solids from the toilet flush hits that friction point and it loses some of that kinetic force. Now, it may not immediately clog, but a little bit of that debris will get left behind. And over the course of many months or years at sometimes, that little bit of debris will just slowly build up and build up until you run into the problem of having a full complete clog. Usually the way to fix that is to replace the pipe, but you can also consider jetting to kind of clear out the debris, reevaluate a few weeks later and see what happened. Overall, another fun and easy one for us to go through today. I hope you found some value in this. If you found this informative in any way, if you gained any value out of it, hit that like button, hit subscribe. I have more videos posted every day on the World of Well and Septic, and I look forward to talking to you guys tomorrow.